So the plot of Star of the Sea is set against the backdrop of the famine, but it follows three characters from three very different social spheres in Ireland of the time. And it starts prior to the famine, and it follows them through 30 years of their lives, during which their lives kind of intersect and intertwine until eventually they all meet on board a famine ship that's bound for New York. Funnily enough, when we approached him, we hadn't realised that anyone else had approached him. We thought we'd just come up with the idea and that we were just lucky to have got to him first. And it was only a couple of weeks ago when we heard him speaking on Arena that we realised that he actually had been approached and had turned people down, which is really amazing.
They had me when they mentioned Irish. You know, I just thought through all of the years of its commercial success, I had a little nagging voice in my head that there was a flaw in the book to do with its treatment of the Irish language. And I would be writing this dialogue set in Connemara in the 1840s or on the famine ship in English. And, you know, I was able to allude to the fact that the famine was obviously a catastrophe for the Irish language, something from which it could never fully recover. But I wasn't really able to embody it on the page in the way that an artist should.
Nor a dog tosa inye concaur lyric ti Mairead, hocrig me hain golly lowert leshen ganfort Blake. Tomedirche stich de rash o tach Delphi, artin yacha me gol lyric.
We're big fans, obviously, of his work, but also it was quite scary showing the production to him because we knew that it would always be a strange experience for him to see his own work on stage. It's inevitably going to be so different, you know. And we couldn't have asked for a more fantastic response from him. He was so positive about it and really, I think, appreciated what we'd taken from the book. We've grown up in Galway, and the Galway International Arts Festival has been very special to us since we were children. We used to go to it every year with our family, and the shows that we saw during the festival were the shows that inspired us really to actually go into theatre in the first place. Shows like Footsparns, Midsummer Night's Dream, fantastic pieces of theatre that were unlike anything we'd ever seen before. And then, you know, we both went away to Glasgow, Mairead and I, and when we came back, the festival had, you know, changed and grown, and the pieces that we saw then, like Political Mother, was a huge influence on us. So it was just incredibly exciting for us to eventually become one of the shows that we're performing at the festival.
Without giving too much away, near the end, there's a scene in the novel of the ship in New York Harbor, and I really thought this couldn't be done on a stage, you know, because it's just too big. It's a very epic scene. The ship gets to New York. It's quarantined for health reason in the harbour with hundreds of other ships. And I just thought it's not possible to do that on Tyveark, but it actually was, and it was incredibly powerful and poignant and emotional, but also very beautiful. And to sit in the middle of the audience and to feel that particular stillness and silence when people are responding to something that's emotionally truthful was an amazing thing, you know. And there was many a little tear shed as well, and I think they really brought out nuances and aspects of the story. I obviously know the book very well. I wrote the book, it's been a big part of my life, but I found their version of it and their presentation of the adaptation just so moving and very emotional. And to hear those words spoken in the Irish language here in Galway for the opening night of Star of the Sea was really something that I'll never forget. Yum, hey.